Right guys, as you can see, they are at the Bhandup pumping. This place is called as it's Bhandup pumping. It's a very nice bird watching place where you can come in and you know you can view a lot of birds, especially the aquatic birds. You'll find a lot of egrets out here feeding in the salt pans. As you can see, there's a large number of salt pans out here. So ideally you'll find a lot of aquatic birds, stilts, herons, egrets. So hope we can see a few, and also other birds like bulbul and many Indian birds, and also the flamingoes if we are lucky enough. So let's see what we can find in here. It's a beautiful place. As you can see, it's the sunset, and I'm hoping that I can show you a lot of birds out here. Let's go guys.
Hi guys, so I finally reached my destination, which is the Bhandup pumping, and as you can see I'm out here. You can see some guys right at the back, so there are a lot of people coming here and to view birds. You can see there is a beautiful lake behind me, if you can see that. So, and there are a lot of mangroves out here, you can see right behind me. So it's completely, it has a lot of space. It's covered up with a lot of mangroves, a lot of trees, if you can see. So hopefully that we get to see a lot of birds out here. This is actual wild sort of trek. I mean, just have a look at the roads, how it is. Just check this out, guys. Have a look at this. In order to take you inside. So let's do something. Let's just give it a try, guys. Okay. Just hold on. I'll just get my... bag in. So we are right into the mangroves here. You can see. You can see these mangroves. Just have a look at the place here.
absolutely quiet. That's why you will find a lot of birds out.
Very you can see that it's not very easy, especially when you're all alone with and you need to manage your camera. It's very difficult. So sun is setting and we're moving inside. Let's check out if we can find any sort of birds or anything. It's very slippery. Let's have a look at this place. It's so quiet. And you move out. See how this place is. It's high tide actually. Very difficult. Finally, water birds. Ideally, we hope that all goes good. Thank you.
guys, I'll just show you all this place. I guess you might have come here. A few of my viewers, a few who know about this place, might have come here. This is where you come, and I guess they have chopped all the branches out here, because earlier when I had come, this was nice, but now they have made a good day out here. So, right. That place there, you can see a little bit of space out here. So in that space you can view all the water birds. So you can just come quietly out here and then you can sit, and you know, if you have a nice lens you can click. Okay guys, can you see the flamingo over there? Yeah, you can see one. I'll zoom in. Wow, I didn't expect this, but I'll come across a flamingo, because this year there isn't any flamingos. Which I'm taking, so this will take you to the altitude. Right, so it's, yes, you have to take a little bit of efforts to get through these bushes. Just make sure that you do not stab anything or any creature. Okay, now can you see a big crane out there? You can see there it is. As soon as I approach there, that crane will fly. It's an egret. It's a big egret out there. There, see, it saw me and they fly. So whenever you come for bird watching or for photography for birds, you just need to make sure that you maintain silence quietly.
Okay guys, can you see those flamingos out there? I'll just try to zoom in. They are at quite a distance, so they are unable to see me because they are not facing me as well, and I'm just hidden behind these grasses trying to, you know, shoot these flamingos. They are lesser flamingos. You can see that they are not pink in color, they are just the juvenile, but it's a great opportunity for me to film them. Flamingos feed on algae, crustaceans and small insects. So this is a way where they disturb the surface of the water so that they can filter food from the mud. Their bills are specially adapted to separate mud or silt from the water, and that's how they eat their food. So flamingos are seen in large numbers, in a large flock in fact, but I can hardly see around 4 of them, and these are lesser flamingos. As you can see that the color of the wings are not pink, so they are juveniles, but it's surprising to see just 4 of them. You know, ideally you find a lot of them and it's just 4 of them, but fortunately this year I have come across flamingos here at Bhandup, where I've been able to spot them. I've been to Shivri and many other places, but I couldn't find any flamingos this year. But this place is quite lucky for me, where I've been able to spot these flamingos. So it's a good sight for me to film them. No, they are just flying away. I guess they might have heard me, the noise, and there they go.
Right, so this is how I film birds, or you know, capture pictures of birds. So all, you can just have a look how what exactly have I done. So you can see that just, you come and you look out for a good place, okay, where you can be seated comfortably like this. You can see I've just left my bag out here, so there's another bag out here, the camera bag. You can see that I've, you know, kept my camera, so
can see that I have nicely kept my camera out here. Okay, on a tripod. I just messed on my tripod. It's you know, it's very difficult to, you know, remove the tripod every time and fix it out. But once you are in a place like this where you film something, so it's very easier once you have a tripod. So you can just, you know, hold it and then you can just move your camera up, down, and you know, film it. It gives a lot of support out here. So you can see I'm just near. You need to also be very patient in such places. You need to be very patient because you don't often find birds. You just need to keep playing the waiting game. So you just need to wait for these birds, you know, to come, and do not disturb them. Do not make a noise, especially because they tend to get, you know, scared and they will just move out of it. They do not like when people are around. So guys, so just need to be quiet and just wait for them. Stuff with you all so that you don't get bored. You just need to make sure that, you know, you're enjoying whatever you're doing. So with this, guys, I hope you all enjoyed the video. I hope you all enjoyed whatever I have filmed. And if you did like, please do subscribe to my channel. Also, please press the like button. And yes, and please do share my videos as well. So till next time, bye.
What is animal? What is that? Is that a dog? It's like so scary, this place. See that? See those eyes? Just get scared of these. Oh, that's not an dog, it's something else. Shit. I don't know, it was I can't understand, but you can see that. Oh shit, these are, you can see that, boss, these are, oh shit, better get out of here. Shit, man, these are, boy, I need to really get out of here because I think that is a fox, to be honest. And thank God I at least have some sort of light with me, because shit, I'm getting scared now. It's just like crazy. I don't know from where it looked like a dog, but it wasn't. It was you know, it was sort of a fox, and there were not even one, there were at least around couple of, you know, at least two or three of those. And you know, they hide in this, which is kind of in make out what exactly it is. You think it's a dog, but then you don't know what it is. Shit, man, I'm like so scared, I'm so nervous right now. And you know, actually I have to head away. Here I am, finally.